First candidate is Google. So if I click on it here, oh, let me go to automatic. I can always change it. Okay, right away, what we have here is good information. See that? So there's a signal from the strategy. And if we take a look at it here, look how Google has been moving. I didn't realize it was this bullish. Long upward subcycles, short downward subcycles, right? So if it continues in this way, as it has been, what you see here is this projection out to just above 150. So taking this trade, all three of my targets are still valid, right? If I want to go to 50%, also something is incorporating more information. Look at that. That was the last high. So if I were looking at this saying, okay, 50% of this subcycle, there's still a little bit here for me to, you know, it's not a bad move at all. In fact, as far as a swing trade, I'd be happy to get that before it hits that potential resistance. If it goes past it, then we have these other extrapolations, of course, based off of the analysis saying there's 75, there's 100. So that's not too bad. I'd go ahead and mark that one. Let's go down to Cisco. All right, here we go. This has not completed its downward cycle at this point. Or actually, no, it has, but it hasn't created a new pivot to the upside. So DPM on automatic is saying, well, this is all the information we have for you at this point. And this is a long signal. So what you're looking for is a move to the upside. This is really nice too as well. Number one, what we have is potential support right here, right? Very, very simple analysis. I'm just using support and resistance for the most part. But to the top here, we have potential resistance and the projected next subcycle will actually end just before that. Now, again, that's pretty aggressive saying, well, I expect this to go all the way to the end there. And it might, but you have these other opportunities, which you have, you know, nice profits up to the 50, 75% as well. So I would mark that as well. All right, let's look at Costco. And remember, as far as keeping in mind the index information, yes, it has been very bearish, but also we saw there was almost a confluence of all four of them saying, but based off cycle information, this might be the time that we see this turn. Here, okay, here's a good example. Costco, we have a signal that has occurred. It's already moved quite a way into the next projection. All right, so in fact, it's already passed the 50% mark. And it is basically tickling the 75% mark if that didn't get it. All right. So what I'm expecting here is for me to make money off this trade, for it to complete this cycle. I'm not saying it won't. I'm saying that that is what would probably have to happen for me to make any money on the long side of this particular trade. And then, of course, using some basic technical analysis, it's resting right below potential resistance. So doesn't look as good of a candidate as we saw with Google and Cisco. We have one more here, S&PS. Okay, this is another good example. Automatic, what we're seeing here is really tight, well, it's a high price, but you can see a tight range relative to this price here for Synopsys. So we have a signal here. What we're seeing is, let me go ahead and flip it. This is when you may wanna just go ahead and flip it. There's a projection based off the cycle analysis. Well, number one, it'd have to break through some pretty well established resistance at this point, all right, in order to hit any of these targets. Okay, you have 50% right there, but that's not very far away, all right? If it does break through, this might be helpful, all right? Then we can go ahead and use this at that point. At this point, it's saying your first target is right at a point where it could stop. This isn't the best moving stock. We looked at four stocks. I thought two of those had good potential to the upside. These two, not as good. And that's basically as simple as it is.